Hey guys, it's Suresh. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning into another video with me today. So I have another exciting Integrity Toys review to share with you guys today. I'm going to be taking a look at a new face doll that came out last summer as part of the Counterculture collection, which of course Jessy Ayala designed. So today we're going to be taking a look at Supernova Colette Duranger. She came out, I believe late last summer, 2018, and then she shipped I think earlier this year or late last year, something like that. She actually is still available at integritytoys.com. It's one of the few dolls that they actually are selling directly now. So if you are interested after watching this review, make sure to head down below to my description box and click on the link. Go ahead and get this tissue off of the box here. And here we are. This is the beautiful purple and hot pink box that Jessy debuted for this collection. I think it was last year for the first time. Let's go ahead and get a look at Colette here. The moment I saw Colette, I have to say, of all the dolls in that collection, Violaine was also really beautiful. She's a new character that came out. But Colette's face and the face paint in this doll, I thought were just beautiful. So I'm very excited. Shall we take a look? Okay. 1, 2, and 3. Oh my God. Mama Rama. Yes, girl. Oh, she's adorable. Ooh. Oh my God. Pink deliciousness. Right away, I am so in love with her beautiful oversized pink coat. I mean, it's like so massive. It's so major. I love her face. Oh my God. So pouty, so moody, so beautiful. Love that lip color, girl. And then here on the side, I see her insanely high boots. They're like not thigh high, they're like crotch high, but girl, okay, I am living. Oh, look at that heel. All right, shall we take a look at the accessories? You guys know I live for the accessories. 1, 2, and 3. Oh my God, look at this beautiful handbag. Oh my God, well, I guess I wouldn't call it a handbag. It's more of like a little backpack, pocketbook type thing. Okay, girl, cute. Love, love, love this bright orange bag. Living, living, living. Okay, and then next to that, I see, I think this is her belt, is it? Or her choker? No, it's her choker. Wow, super chic. It's like bright orange and fuchsia. Living. And then next to that, I see her additional pair of hands with a really beautiful fuchsia manicure. And then I see her gorgeous jewelry suite. Wow, look at that head jewelry. I see a moon. I see a star and tons of bangles. Oh my God, how exciting. Since the new accessory pouches just do not stay closed at all, oh my God, I'm just gonna go ahead and take all of her little accessories out of here. We'll keep them aside for now so that we can get her out of the box. I also wanna get these boots out, but no bueno, not happening. So the inner carton lifts out just like so, as always, just like that. There she is in the back, tied down with gray silk ribbons. And then we see her new face stand underneath here. There we go. And it's that really interesting slanted black base there. We have the silica gel back here and the vents on the side of this box here. It's that beautiful matte gunmetal gray color. And then underneath that, we see her certificate of authenticity. It's the beautiful new face certificate that we have now grown to see and love with the edition size on it, which is 1200. I really don't know much about street style and street fashion, like at all. It's one of the other reasons why I don't really review a lot of the other, you know, pop culture street inspired dolls, because I just have no idea what I'm looking at. To me, it kind of all looks not cute sometimes. I just kind of stay in my lane. Do you know what I mean? I know fashion. I know, you know, couture, I know haute couture, I know really beautiful traditional women's wear and men's wear. I don't really know a lot of what's happening in the new fashion world. I don't really even watch a lot of the shows anymore. I know that Jessy is a lot more in tune with that side of fashion, so I think it's perfect that he designed these collections. Oh my God, how beautiful is that? Like, see, I wouldn't even know where to begin with this. So I'm appreciative of what I see, and that's really where my street style stops. Oh, yay! Oh my God, oh, look at that hair. I forgot how long it is. Yes, Mama Rama. Oh, this feels like butter. Oh, so pretty. So much pink, so much pink. And we just passed National Pink Day, so it's very fitting. I think pink might have taken over as my absolute favorite color instead of blue. Oh, and she has henna on her hands? Oh, gorge. In case you're wondering, I actually don't look at the promotional photos before I do a review because I want to be like fully surprised. And I don't watch other reviews. The only thing I'll do is sometimes look up the doll just to like get a better idea of like their edition size or their story a little bit, so in case I have to reference it for anything in the video, but I really like to go in quite blind. What a pretty doll. I really also like the ethnic ambiguity here. Do you know what I mean? I think that's something that Jessy does so well. Kudos to him on that. All right, we're gonna go ahead and get her knee guards off here. And I'm also gonna get these boots out of this box. See, these are the things that tear at my fingers and then they just look like gross hell when you guys see them up close. What you gonna do, y'all? What you gonna do? I really wish these accessory packs would just come out of the box. It's such a pain in the butt that they don't. Look at this, like I can't even get this out of here. Look at these boots. Oh my God. That is a boot hand. Love. There's a platform on here, oh my God. Of course, a functioning zipper. Oh, it's so exciting. Let me go ahead and get all of her accessories on and I'll be right back. Okay. Here is Supernova Colette Duranger fully dressed in all of her accessories. Well, almost all. I can't get the bangles on because of her coat, so we'll put them on when we take the coat off. You guys, she is so freaking pretty. Oh my God. All this pink, all this orange, yes, and yes. And these like lavender metallic boots. Oh. P.S. They are a little bit difficult to get on in true integrity style, so did rip up my fingers again, so just a heads up on that. But they are fully functioning zippers, which obviously is so magical. Love this coat so much. I did put her beautiful little tika on her head. I love that Jessy kind of incorporated that into this cool casual culture type of vibe, you know? So that is beautiful. There is a little peek at her outfit on the inside. Oh my God, look at that coat. It's fully lined. Oh, all these colors are just so juicy and good together. There is her beautiful little ring. She still has her little IT hang tag on here, which we'll take off in a little bit. And then here is her sweet little bag. It's so cute, right? And here is Colette without her beautiful big faux fur coat on. Here is what is underneath. And oh my goodness, it is so freaking adorable. This really beautiful purple mesh top with a silver sequin bandeau sewn into the top. How cool is that, right? You can really see the choker now, the beautiful contrasting colors. I feel like this orange and bright pink are such a classic combo, especially in the doll world. Love. I know there's like a number of Barbies that have that color combo and I'm living. And here are all her delicious bangles. Oh my God, you guys, there's so many of them. It's like Starburst, I love it. So much beautiful color. I love this little faux leather skirt, mini skirt, with the little grommet and ring detail here. So cool. Like definitely very rebellious, counterculture-y, kind of going against the grain, but like fashion. Do you know what I mean? It's like, okay, make it fashion. And she's definitely living up to it. Let's go ahead and just get a better look at some of Colette's pieces here. I see all the closures back here, which is gorgeous. I'm dreading taking these boots off because they're not easy to get on. It's always just, I don't know why they're so difficult to get on. It's not the top portion of the boot. It's like getting her foot in it, you know? I don't know if you guys are having that same problem. If you are, oh, I dropped a ring somewhere. If you're having that same problem, please let me know how you alleviate that problem. So I'll be very grateful. I feel like so many of you guys are like veteran integrity toys collectors. And I'm always so thankful and grateful for your very generous advice. Getting her foot in and out of this is like so hard. And then when I push the zipper down like this, that's what like eats at my fingers. And then they just look like crapola. And then they just get like a little bit ruined here, but What you gonna do, girl? It's wear and tear, I guess. You know. Oh, it's a bodysuit. Smart. There is her bodysuit. Super cute. I mean, it could be like its own ensemble, right? And there we see all the closures for this top. So definitely like street, but make it fashion. You know, street, but make it couture, because a lot of bodysuits wouldn't have these kinds of closures. Do you know what I'm saying? By the way, you guys, her other set of spare hands do not have the henna on it, just the hands that she's wearing. Here is Supernova Colette Duranger in the buff so that you guys can get a look at her gorgeous new face physique. This is the same body that I have seen before on other new face dolls of mine. Specifically Erin Salston, because you guys know I love me some Erin. Let's go ahead and start with her face. Oh my goodness. Just so moody and so freaking cute. I love the makeup. I love the green eyes. She does have applied lashes there that you can see on the side. And unlike Lady Aurelia's the week before last, they are not out of control and they actually fit her eyes. So yeah, love that. The makeup is beautiful. Beautiful earth tones in the crease with like a little bit of a brighter color on her lid there. Winged cat eyes, really beautifully done brows. This is definitely like a very Jessy beat, don't you think? Bright fuchsia pink lips, which I am living for. I left her jewelry on, obviously, so that you guys can see it on the form. There is her little moon earring there, which ties into her beautiful choker and that little ring on it. And then on the right hand side, she has a little star, very celestial indeed. And then her head jewelry is so beautiful. It also has a little moon towards the back there at the end of it that is currently tucked into her hair. But it comes with a little pin that is really easy to use and kind of pin into her hair. So I love that. The pendant portion of the Tika is really beautiful. It's a little teardrop shape with a little purplish stone in the center. It actually ties really beautifully to her ring because her ring has an orange stone in it. It's almost very similar in its shape and design. Here are her beautiful bangles. Here are one set of it. We see lots of these beautiful bangles in this bright neon yellow and then orange here. And then we have silver bangles that alternate in stone color from orange to purple. There is a close-up of her beautiful henna on her hands. They are really, really beautiful and intricate, and I love them. She has a bright pink fuchsia manicure that matches her lip color quite nicely. There on the other side, we see the exact same thing. And then we also see her beautiful little moon-shaped ring on that hand. Just gorgeous. I just love all the jewelry. Oh my God, y'all know I am such a sucker for good jewelry, although this Tika loves to turn on its side. And then her hair is really, really pretty as well. It's a gorgeous, warm blonde color, like a honey almost. Has like a nice little wave to it, and it's cut pretty blunt there at the bottom. It passes her bum, so it's really long. Love that. It needs a little bit of a good brush through, I think, just to bring back its life a little bit. And then she has a pedicure here as well. Beautiful arched new face feet, which are a little bit smaller than FR for those of you guys who are new to IT. And in terms of articulation, she moves here at the shoulder, here at the elbow, of course, here at the wrist with interchangeable hands. She moves here at her head, obviously, and then under her breastplate as well. Just like so. This does actually pop off. Her arms actually pop off from there, which is so easy to get her into outfits that are a little bit more challenging. And then she has a little belly button here, darling. And then her legs kick out like so. Her knees kick just like that. And then her legs actually kick out as well. And then you can see the ball bearing, plastic ball bearing mechanism that makes her joints move. Really beautiful articulation. Y'all know if you followed me on my IT journey here that I have fallen in love with these dolls so much. Here she is from the back. Just look how beautiful that elbow is. So nice, right? Like such a beautifully done articulation. The impression of back dimples here and then her little bum. And then, yeah, just like so. A really, really lovely doll. I love her. Here is her sweet little purple jumpsuit. It is a soft mesh fabric with a row, or multiple rows actually, of silver sequins going across the bust to cover that area and give her some modesty. It's long sleeved, so beautifully tailored. Here in the back we see a whole row of closures, 1, 2, 3, 4 silver hooks with corresponding thread loops on the other side. The cuffs are finished off nicely with a little bit of ribbon trim, as is the neckline here. So that is just really, really beautiful. And again, couture style, gorgeous. There's the inside of the bust bandeau portion there. So you can see the underside of that fabric. Lovely, what a cute little piece indeed. Here's her beautiful little neon pink mini skirt. Such a darling little piece. This is definitely giving me like Barbie vibes. In person, it's actually almost more like Pepto-Bismol pink. I will say on camera, I feel like it's a little bit warmer almost, or cooler maybe, maybe cooler. But all the same, it feels really nice, like very substantial feeling. It's fully lined all the way through with this beautiful silk fabric. The composition of the skirt itself is like a really soft faux leather. If you look up close, there's even the striations of leather markings on there. So I love that detail. Here in the back, we see 2 silver hooks there, and then 2 thread loops, and then a facing here as well in the same lining fabric. There is her integrity tag there on the inside. And then we see this little detail here of these little jump rings and kind of grommets going through the piece. So cute, like definitely very like punk rockery, but again, fashion. Here is her exquisite, gorgeous faux fur oversized coat. I feel like many of you guys who have this doll have had so much fun with this piece. I've seen it on all sorts of dolls over the past few months, and I don't blame you. This is actually one of the pieces that really made me fall in love with this doll. It's so, so pretty. What a beautiful shade of pink. I feel like this faux fur is almost very like multifaceted in person. It looks different at many, at different angles. It reminds me a lot of the purse portion of Eye Candy Reina Amati's like ice cream cone purse. The little poof top looks very similar to this fabric, but there's also lots of different like multicolored metallic confetti strewn in to the faux fur. So what a beautiful little touch indeed. I feel like I could definitely see a girl or a boy like wearing this to like a cool rave party. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't even know if that's a thing anymore, but yeah, we'll just go ahead and say it. Here is the inside. So beautiful. Just look at that beautiful pink lining. Gorgeous silk fabric with a nice sheen to it in a soft shade of pink. Fully lined sleeves there. I mean, just magical. This faux fur fabric is not easy to sew. So I'm always just in awe when they do such a nice job of it. You know what I mean? Look how beautifully that hem is done. Look how nicely these seams are done. And look at the neckline. It's like just magical, so neat. There's her IT tag. I mean, just freaking exquisite. If I could like zap this into human style size, I would. It feels like there might be pockets here, but I don't think so. No, yes, no. That would have been like a little extra, no? But yeah, you can't really see where the seams are on the outside, as with most, you know, fur and faux fur, it's hard to tell, but just a really, really beautiful piece. I love this. If you are thinking about getting this doll, this alone is just worth it, I think. Just magical. Here are her beautiful boots up close, out of her feet slash legs so that you guys can see them. They are definitely like a thigh high, almost like crotch high kind of boot. Really, really beautiful material here. I love, love, love this color. It's like the most gorgeous shade of like lavender, metallic lavender with this purple platform and heel detail with a live zipper that goes all the way up and down the boot. The inside is just the back portion of the faux leather. And then you can see where the zipper has been sewn and then glued down. You know, I appreciate being able to see a little bit of the construction. So yeah, I love that. Just exquisite. Like, what a fun, fun addition to my doll closet, you know? Here is her beautiful little super cute handbag. It's a bright, bright orange color. I'm not sure if it's even translating on camera, like how bright it actually is. It's definitely neon. There is a little impression here of this toggle that was like sitting like this. in the bag, so that's gonna have to kind of work itself out. But I love this little chain detail. I think it's so cool. Like, what an interesting little touch, right? Love. And there's a big ring here that connects the little bag to the handle. Just so freaking cool. I know that this is referencing a recent designer that we saw this in. I can't think of who at the moment, but it is just such a beautiful little piece. So creative. I love the little strap detail here on the handle, the silver jump ring, of course. It's almost like a little knapsack that's attached to this. So let's go ahead and see what the inside of it looks like. You actually don't have to disconnect that little chain, so that's nice. Here we go. As with all integrity bags, it opens, and then if you can get your little finger in there, it is lined and ready for you to put your cell phone in. Magnetic closure, just like so. Really beautiful top stitch detail here all the way around in a same corresponding thread color. Just lovely. What a beautiful little piece, especially for me, because I don't see a lot of these types of silhouettes in my dolls. So I am really appreciating this. Thanks, Jessy, for giving us something totally cute and new. So there we have it, guys. This is the gorgeous Supernova Colette Duranger from the 2018 New Face Collection for Integrity Toys. She is themed counterculture. That's part of her whole clan. And that she definitely is, but oh my goodness, she definitely made it fashion. If you guys are interested in picking her up and adding her to your collection, she is still available at integritytoys.com. Make sure to scroll down below and check out the link in my description box. Beautiful job, Jessy, as always. You know I love you, girl. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that you learned something. Please be sure to give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Make sure to hit that little bell icon after the subscribe button. That way you guys will be notified every Thursday when I upload a new video. Find me on Instagram, I'm at SureshNY. That's generally where I post all my updates. And until I see you guys again, Colette and I are heading over to Capitol Hill, which is the more counterculture portion of Seattle. Well, it used to be before gentrification kicked in. We're gonna go out for a couple of drinks. She's gonna introduce me to some of her friends who are in Seattle for the weekend. And yeah, we're just gonna have a blast being, you know, rebellious and counterculture-y. Wherever you guys are, I hope you're having a fantastic day. Big hugs and kisses from me and Colette here in Seattle. Mwah! Happy Pride. I love all of you so much. Thank you guys for all of your continued support. Wherever you are, I hope you're celebrating Pride in whatever way that you can. Just know that I'm thinking of you and sending you so much love. And I'll see you guys again next Thursday for another video, okay? Bye.